Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to talk to you about the term statistical significance. This term tells how sure you are that a difference or relationship exists and that you are confident that the relationship is real, not that you just got lucky or unlucky in choosing the sample. Statistical significance does not tell the whole story. Many times the word significant is used to describe a relationship because it will help someone make a decision. But this can be misleading because it doesn't speak to practical significance. Consider these scenarios. A diet claims statistical significance in the results for people who followed their plan and reported that clients lost an average of 2.7 pounds during the year-long study. Well, maybe they did statistically prove that these results were significant, but think about the practicality of that. Would you be willing to join a diet program and put everything into it to get 2.7 pounds reduction at the end of a year? Most people wouldn't. So even though something's significant there, it doesn't mean that it would cause people to want to participate or use that particular diet. The second one, a hospital study showed that by increasing the housekeeping staff by 20%, there was a 26% reduction in patient-related infections. Well, of course, somebody's looking to always reduce the patient infections, but is it even practical to think that they could add 20% more housekeeping staff? That would be a huge increase in funding for that, and not to the least to say there might not be even a way to keep everybody on the floor with that many more people. So it may not be a practical solution, even though we might say, wow, well, if you could do that, you could, you know, reduce infections. It's a little tricky to speak about statistical significance at this point in the course because there are many vocabulary terms that we're not addressing at this time, like p-value and null hypothesis. But let's agree to think of 5% as the cutoff for determining if something is statistically significant. And I'm going to say an example for you rather than give you a definition at this time. So let's think about this, the sex of your baby. You should know that you have a 50% chance of having a girl and a 50% chance of having a boy. And if we look at all the birth records for so many years, looking at millions and millions, it comes out to be about 50-50. So let's say that someone marketed a drug that would lead to the birth of girls over boys, and they administered the drug to 20 women, and 18 of them gave birth to girls. In that case, we would say that those are statistically significant results, because the percent chance of that happening without the intervention of that medication would be 0.018%, or in other words, less than 5% of the time, if you went out and just randomly selected 20 women and then looked at the gender or the sex of their baby, they would less than 0.2% of a time of a percent would they have 18 girls. So the fact that they took the medication and then got this result means that that medication must be working, because it's highly unlikely that that would happen unless they intervened in some way. If the same drug was administered to 20 people and 12 girls were born to women, we would say that that was not significant, because the chance of having 12 girls in 20 births without any intervention is about 12%, and that is greater than 5%. So if you can see something happening without intervention at a rate higher than 5%, then we usually aren't able to say that our intervention made a big difference. Okay, have a fantastic day. We'll talk to you next.